Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we're going to look at redox pairs and common oxidizing and reducing reagents.
When it comes to redox, my favorite mnemonic is Leo the Lion says, "Grrr," which tells us that the loss of electrons is equal to oxidation, and the gain of electrons is equal to reduction. I like this better than oil rig, which stands for oxidation is loss and reduction is gain, because it doesn't tell us what we're gaining and what we're losing, and the mnemonic that's confusing is not worth the time. Leo the Lion says, "Grrr," clearly tells us loss of electrons is oxidation, gain of electrons is reduction, but we have to remember that they are connected to each other. Say I walk into a deli and try to order a sandwich. The sandwich costs $5, so I hand $5 to the cashier. The cashier hands me a sandwich. I want the sandwich, but in the process of acquiring a sandwich, I have lost $5. That means the deli, in the process of gaining $5, has caused me to lose $5. They can't gain my money without me having a loss. With oxidation and reduction, if there is a transfer of electrons, something can only gain electrons if something else loses the electrons. That means redox reactions have to be paired where the same number of electrons are gained from one and lost from the other, where the total electrons lost in one half of the reaction have to be gained in the other half of the reaction. That's why they're called redox pairs, red-ox, reduction-oxidation. What are the consumers and cashiers of redox reactions? In this reaction, as we'll learn in the next video, SN, or tin, is oxidized, and iron is reduced. When SN2+ is getting oxidized, in the process of getting oxidized, it is causing the iron to get reduced. And at the same time, when the iron 3+ is getting reduced, it is causing the SN to get oxidized. This means that when SN2+ gets oxidized, it acts as the reducing agent or the reductant. And when iron 3+ gets reduced, it acts as the oxidizing agent or the oxidant. We'll look at redox reactions in more detail in the next video. But first, let's look at some common oxidizing and reducing reagents. From the mnemonic, Leo says "Grrr," we know that something that has a loss of electrons is going to be oxidation, and a gain of electrons is reduction. But I want you to take that a step further. Electrons, when they're added to a proton, gives us a hydrogen atom. So you can think of oxidation as the loss of a hydrogen atom. If reduction is the gain of an electron, and electrons and protons together give us hydrogen atoms, then we can assume that reduction is the gain of a hydrogen atom. In general chemistry, you typically looked at just electrons, but in organic chemistry and biochemistry, you've seen redox that involved oxygen atoms. Think about your alkene reduction, where you added hydrogens. That's the hydrogen atom. That's a reduction reaction. Think about the oxidation of an alcohol. We lost a hydrogen atom, but we also gained a bond to the oxygen atom. Oxygen and hydrogen tend to be the opposite of each other, so another way to think of oxidation is loss of hydrogen or the gain of oxygen, and reduction would be the gain of hydrogen or the loss of oxygen. If I turn that carbonyl into an alcohol, that's a reduction because I lost a bond to oxygen. What does this have to do with reducing agents? When you're looking at the molecules, instead of just memorizing what they are, try to pay attention to what we would expect on an agent of oxidation or an agent of reduction. You can download the Common Oxidizing and Reducing Reagents cheat sheet on my website linked below, but let's look at some of them first. In general chemistry, you've seen a lot of oxidizing and reducing agents as simple metals, and I wouldn't memorize any of them because a metal will act as an oxidizing agent under certain conditions, but that same metal can act as a reducing reagent under other conditions. Think back to what you covered in electrochemistry. But in organic chemistry, you learned a list like lithium aluminum hydride, also called LAH, sodium borohydride, sodium hydride, H2 gas, H2 in a Lindlar's catalyst. What do you notice with each of these reducing agents? If a reducing agent is going to cause something to be reduced, that means the something has to gain electrons or gain hydrogens. Shouldn't the agent that causes something to gain electrons or hydrogens have plenty of hydrogens to provide? Reducing agent with four hydrogens, four hydrogen, one hydrogen, two hydrogen. That's an easy way to remember it. And let's not forget from biochemistry, NADH and FADH2. Once more, hydrogen and lots of hydrogen. We mentioned metals can act as oxidizing or reducing agents. If oxidizing agents are going to cause a loss of electrons, they're also going to cause a gain of oxygen. And the way to remember that is oxidizing has oxygen in the name. It causes something else to gain oxygen. So what do you expect to see in your oxidizing agents? Oxygen. In general chemistry, you would have seen O2, peroxides like H2O2, and some strong acids like H2SO4. In organic chemistry, you would have seen KMnO4, H2Cr2O7, or some version of chromic acid, more O2, PCC, which if you think about it, is pyridinium chlorochromate, more chromic acid variations, and in biochem, NAD+, and FADH. Once again, what do we see? Oxygen, 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 more oxygen, there's oxygen hiding in there. And this one's a little tricky because we don't appear to see any oxygens in the NAD+ or FADH. So instead, look at the hydrogen balance. The reducing agent has more hydrogen than the oxidizing agent, which in NAD just has a positive charge. In FAD, the reducing agent has two hydrogen atoms. The oxidizing agent only has one. Be sure to join me in the next video where we look at oxidation and reduction reactions in more detail. First, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss when I post new videos. Then visit my website, layerforsci.com/reactions, for the entire MCAT stoichiometry video series along with a practice quiz and cheat sheet.